I was traveling through the deep galaxy when something unexpected happened. An asteroid field came out of nowhere. One of the asteroids damaged the hyperdrive, and I had to make an emergency landing on an unknown planet, which was close. What the hell? The spaceship crashed unpleasantly, and as I came back to consciousness, I realized in which strange environment I found myself. This planet contains strange creatures, alien of all kinds, with even stranger but marvelous constructions, buildings, and large objects. And a lot of light. I asked myself, what can I expect from this planet and these people? I was looking around and exploring this marvelous environment for 2 days, talking to these beautiful, but seemingly confused creatures. They really wanted to help, but had no idea who can fix the hyperdrive. But then, I finally looked into the newspaper of this planet. It looked like there was a fortune teller in town. Intense intuition.
Got a burning question? Need some perspective?
Hell yes, I have a question and I need an answer. I explained my problem to the tarot lady and she said she will guide me to the person who will solve my problem. Well, awesome! So I took one of the angel cards, Nemetona, symbolizing with a sacred space, the sacred temple, and in there, the dragon lady lives. So she will solve my problem.
Hello, stranger. I can help you, but first you have to solve this riddle.
Bring me the stick of a bird.
What?
Bring me the stick of a bird. Look for it, think about it, find it out and bring it to me.
The stick of a bird. The stick of a bird. I began searching my mind and sent my thoughts through the pathways of my brain. What could the dragon lady could mean with the stick of a bird? The stick of a bird. Bird. Stick. Stick. Bird. I simply couldn't find the answer. What could it be? What does she mean? And then, suddenly, it struck my mind.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Okay, Dragon Lady, I have the answer.
Ostrich Bilton. That's not the answer. Sorry. I meant the nest. But you know what, stranger? For being extra creative, I will help you.
She sent me to the grease monkeys and they fix everything.
You need your bike, your spaceship fixed. We come to the grease monkeys and we can help you. We have all special monkey tools, monkey wrench, monkey hammer. I think your spaceship will be fixed in no time. So I've had a look in the shop and I think the monkey play amplifier will be the best tool for you to fix your spaceship with.
Wicked.
Journey well.
Oh no! Since I was an alien, I couldn't work with my alien hands with their tools. It always slipped out of my hands. I was so close to escape here. And now all hope is gone. So what to do? I was devastated. Being trapped here, I decided to make the best out of it. I joined the energy of the people and went down the rabbit hole. Deep down, deep down. I saw things I never saw in my life before. Was it the alien booth? Or was it just my imagination? Or was I dreaming? Great time meeting amazing people, and I was willing to go all in that night. And then this light got my attention. I followed the light. That looks cozy. Let me sit here for a second, or better lay down. So I looked into the sky and I watched this beautiful game of lights. And then the lights went off. And I drifted off into this black hole while finally losing consciousness.
Hello, stranger. It's me, the spirit of water. I found you, here in the desert. You were all alone and unconscious. Luckily I found you. Come, you're at Sunset Oasis. You're safe now. I'll bring you some water.
The spirit of the wind saved my life that night. So I took a very nice shower here and fully regained my energy in this charming oasis, and was ready to continue my quest. Next stop, Heartburn.
Hi stranger, welcome to the burn. I'm glad you found us. You found Allegra. Now Allegra goes about graft and addicts. First three letters of a lamb gives you Allegra. And our symbol, which we would like to present to you, is a heart with a double infinity. They bring you much and much and much more love and prosperity.
One beautiful day, we have decided to get married and design our wedding rings. And we were making these beautiful designs, hiding it from each other. I was making mine, he was making his. And when the D-Day came, we came with the same design, and double infinity. And this is how Allegra started. We put the double infinity into her heart and made it our sign.
Stranger, take it and be it, and may you find your way.
Thank you, people.
The Heartburn couple told me that people from the steampunk saloon would guide me to the bad mechanics, who also fix everything.
Hello, stranger. I don't know bad mechanics, but I think there's somebody at State of Bliss that does.
Us. You must find us in the dust. Look across the player large.
Clive.
Look across the player, my love.
Clive, you haven't
my love.
You haven't made the bed.
The bed, the bed.
You haven't made the bed again. Don't make the bed, Clive. I'll deal with this one.
Help, help. What you seek lies far and near. Within our scope, within the player, find thyself amongst the dust.
What do we
play, 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 play. He doesn't need to know. He doesn't need to know. There's no need.
He doesn't want to play.
He doesn't want to play. He doesn't need to know. The play you seek is not the play you want. So. Either you can come down to this planet, you come down here, right now, right here, come and sit down on this planet, and fucking, no!
We didn't like that. We didn't like that shit, okay?
Clive, why are you doing the silly voice? Look at his
I'm sorry, I don't know. I do apologize. It may be the nipples. Like, he's got very alien nipples. His nipples, they're good, but they're strong. They're strong nipples, and I fear it. Look!
Must be going.
Why must you always do this?
I have no idea where this is leading.
Say, who the fuck is this guy? Who the fuck are you?
Who the fuck is this guy?
Not so we've been terribly helpful to this young traveller from Antiglad. So,
these guys from State of Bliss talked a lot of miracles. But finally, it became clear to me that the only people that know where I can fix the hyperdrive are the wise queen and king of AfrikaBurn. Since they are the mightiest people on this planet, I thought I need something to give in exchange. Something precious. Something worth giving. Something royal. Yes, I will get some gold.
I don't know if you're from this planet, it's but look at this planet.
But first I have to earn it. But where? Of course, the rangers. Range running is one of the best parts here. Actually, you do play nothing, but look freaking cool and fucking important at the same time. And it's a hell of fun, because you meet a lot of awesome people from all over this planet. So in the end, I earned my gold, and I was finally ready to meet the queen and king of AfrikaBurn.
So you want us to help you, stranger?
Yes, please, your mighty rulers.
What can you offer in exchange? Gold? You brought gold? Listen up, stranger. We are the richest people on this planet. We eat gold for breakfast. Sorry, we don't need your gold.
Okay, wait. I can give you something which is way more precious than gold.
What is this?
I bring you, on the middle of the day, to the top of the waiting queue for ice. Yes, it's always handy to be a ranger. And so they helped me, and my hyperdrive was fixed in no time. I could finally leave this place, but the wise words of the AfrikaBurn queen were ringing in my ears.
You know what, stranger? Things are different here. It's not about how much money or gold you have, or what status you are. Here it is just about you and your personality. We are king and queen of this planet, not because we have the most gold, wealth, or prosperity, but because we respect our people the most and care about them as they were our own children.
I had a great time here. I met amazing people with whom I connected on a much higher level than any time before. I felt so powerful because all this raised my energy and my feel-good factor to the moon. I mean, look at all these beautiful people. Look how friendly and peaceful this life is on this planet. At first, I wanted to escape. But now... I will stay!